Chest pain is one of the most frequent reasons people come to the emergency department. Its numerous causes range from benign to life-threatening, with overlapping symptoms making identification of serious problems difficult. Our goal is to tease out who is having, or at risk of having, an emergent problem. Symptoms of chest pain can be caused by acute coronary syndromes from myocardial ischemia or angina, or can have a non-cardiac origin. The most severe life-threatening causes of chest pain can be remembered using the mnemonic MAP IT: myocardial infarction, aortic dissection or aneurysm, pulmonary embolus, pericarditis and pneumothorax, intestinal causes, tamponade. Patients may describe crushing chest pain like an elephant sitting on my chest that radiates to the jaw or left shoulder and arm. They may sweat a lot, can't get comfortable, are anxious, vomiting, have shortness of breath, or feel faint. Heart attacks may present atypically, especially in women, elderly, and diabetics. Unfortunately, these same symptoms characterize those suffering from thoracic aortic dissection or rupturing aneurysm. Sometimes patients complain of tearing chest pain radiating through to the upper back. Pericardial effusion itself may not be life-threatening, but progression to tamponade causes obstructive shock. It can occur from trauma, cancer, or pericardial inflammation like in pericarditis. Pulmonary embolus causes chest or back pain, especially when deep breathing, and may occur with shortness of breath, low oxygen saturation, or tachycardia. Pneumothorax can be traumatic or spontaneous, with introduction of air into the pleural space gradually forcing the lung to shrink. It can progress to tension pneumothorax, an immediate life-threatening process. Intestinal problems like gastritis or acid reflux disease are frequent benign mimickers of dangerous chest pain etiologies. But others, like bleeding peptic ulcers or cholecystitis, may be fatal. Evaluating chest pain can be a difficult process. In emergent situations, there may not be time to wait for lab work or imaging studies, and physical examination is often not sensitive enough to make a definitive diagnosis. Point-of-care ultrasound has become crucial to diagnosing these conditions quickly, leading to faster management, improved patient care, and lives saved.